Hi friends, so today I'm gonna show you how we've set up a charcuterie board for a going away party for our friends. He got a job in California, so they're moving, they're empty nesters anyway, but they've been here, we've been friends for 20 years, so we're throwing them a party, and it's a wine tasting. We have a sommelier coming, and he has a list of wines, and then the charcuterie, and I'll be making salmon, so I'll just show you kind of how I've set it up. Hope you enjoy. Okay, so what I've done is I've extended our kitchen table. It's an extendable one, it's built in, and I've just laid out some craft paper, and all the boards that I have, I'm gonna be putting it here. Those are the cheeses that I got. I just went to the regular grocery store versus a specialty shop or even Costco because I wanted to have different types of cheese instead of the same cheese that you always get at Costco. Although I wish I had the Manchego cheese there. And then over here, you just kind of see the mess, the process of when you're preparing for a party. I did do the dishes last night, so those have to be put away. And here are some of the boards that I've washed and letting them dry. And then behind me is just kind of all this stuff. So there's some fruit there. Crackers, nuts, I got some artichokes, fruit, fig spread and stuff like that. More fruit, crackers, dried fruit, and olives back here. And then I did get some rosemary to kind of garnish and make it prettier, I guess. Add some green, since there won't be a lot of green in the charcuterie except for the green grapes. And then instead of getting pre-packaged deli, like the prosciutto and salami, I did get it from the deli department. It is better. So what you could do in a smaller scale is just try the different meats, you know, a quarter pound, and have them slice it the way you'd have it for charcuterie, so that the next time when you have a party or a gathering, you know which ones to go for. So I know that their salami and their prosciutto, turkey, ham, I have those too. Are really good. And then I think the salmon is already in the fridge. The dishes have been put away, so I went ahead and put the cutting boards here so that they will dry better. And then my daughter is soaking the fruit in what, vinegar and water. All right, so what I've done is I've just put a towel there, the cutting board on top, got my chef knife, but you can use, obviously, cheese cutting knife. Got my scissors, and then I've already cut the bars of chocolate. I have three different types there, dark sea salt and dark orange. Okay, I'm gonna do the brie cheese because that's one of the easier of the cheeses that I bought that are easy to cut. And this is gonna be really simple. And then I think I'm just gonna time lapse the other cheeses, maybe not all of them, but you kind of get an idea. So probably the best thing here is just to set the trash there for now. So I'm gonna cut it in half. And you know, there are YouTube channels, probably TikTok also, and Instagram dedicated just to grazing boards or charcuterie boards. So just follow them. They have amazing ideas. I get my ideas from them, at least new ones that I haven't done before. So this, you see that I cut it in half, then I cut it in half again to make quarters. And now these are eighths, okay? So just imagine that was half, then I cut it in half again. And so what I'm gonna do, for me, this is too big. So I'm just gonna cut those in half again. So basically there's gonna be 16 pieces of these brie cheese, and they're I call them pinwheels, you know, so they kind of just stay that type of shape, the triangles. These I'm probably just gonna layer on top of each other in a circle. So example, let me just do four, like a few of these. So you have that one there, then another, just a layer, but keeping the circle. And then you could take like a blackberry and put in there and put some rosemary too. Of course, make sure you've washed your hands. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna take the same type of cheese, since I have two Bries here, I'm just gonna put it in this bowl and just leave it there. And then I have a second one that I'm gonna cut exactly the same, but you can style it differently on the board. Put it in the same bowl, you can cover it in saran wrap, and then when you're ready to place it, you could just take it out of the fridge. So one of the things for sure, you have to serve cheese at room temperature. So the party starts at 5:30. I have the sommelier coming at 5, a friend's coming at 5 to just do some last touches to whatever we need to for the party or cleaning, whatever. So I think I'm gonna lay it out maybe by 4:30, the latest, probably start at 4, because I think it'll take me an hour to lay everything out. And then for the chocolate, I'm doing the same thing. I'm just getting a smaller bowl and putting the different chocolates in here. And I think I wanna keep them separate. Like this is one flavor, I think this is the orange. And then this one is the dark chocolate. This is the sea salt. So if you run out of bowls, use mini plates, use paper plates, use big plates. You're gonna need some space, as you saw earlier in my kitchen. We're basically using the whole space. And I think I have a medium-sized kitchen. It's not the biggest kitchen, but you can still make it happen. If you have a dining room table, coffee table, side tables, just spread it all out. No one's gonna know. It's just gonna look beautiful for the party. And also, I have chocolate here. I have truffles and a little bit of lemon cake, which is, you know, kind of like a sponge cake that I'm gonna put throughout the charcuterie board also, because I don't want to have a separate dessert table. So that's up to you. I do have, my friend is bringing carrot cake, so that's gonna be by itself. The pièce de résistance is gonna be the charcuterie board. So I don't need the cake to overpower that, so it's separate. Okay, I'm doing the second brie. And a little tip I have for you is when you're preparing for a party, just make sure you start out with a empty and clean trash can with a new trash bag in there, because I don't know, I think mentally for me, when the trash gets full, I feel like everything stops. So you just wanna keep your mojo going and your process going. So yeah, I just have a clean trash bag in the beginning and clean it, empty it along the way. Those are just little things. Okay, so half. Now, if you do want it a little bit different in your charcuterie board, like you want a big piece and then you have different cheese around it, you could do it that way. But like I said, I've already decided this is how I'm gonna do it. Since I have about 8 or 9 different cheeses here, I think we're gonna have different types of slices, so that will be good. And this is the only cheese I got that is a circle, because sometimes they have like smoked Gouda, which is my favorite, in a circle. But these are the ones I wanted to keep with this type of cut. Okay. And second to last slice and one more slice. Yeah, let me know in the comments if you have any tips for when you do a charcuterie board. I have 30 guests coming. So I was contemplating if I should have food with the charcuterie board, because you know, it has the meat, it has everything. And I looked online and they're basically saying salads. So I do have one small side salad that I'm serving, but I thought, let me just add the salmon because it is dinner and is a Friday night. And that's the time when most people are going out for dinner. So I thought I'd have something more substantial. So that's why I have the salmon, the charcuterie board, and a little salad. All right, another tip I have is, since it is a wine tasting party, I did get a bio from the sommelier. And then he listed out very, very nicely the wines that we will be tasting. So I printed that out and I'm putting it in a picture frame. I'll show you that in a little while. So here's the brie cheese, two small round brie cheese that I've cut into triangles, and I've covered it with the plastic wrap, and I'll be putting it in the fridge. All right, I did realize that I will be going to the other store to get the manchego cheese, which is Spanish, I believe. That's already cut into triangles. That is a great cheese and a great cut. And great cut meaning for your charcuterie, it's gonna be really pretty. You've seen it all the time. But I have to go back for that because the store I went to was too expensive. And I knew the other one was cheaper at my other grocery store. So this is a block of cheese. And I have here Vermont cheddar. And these usually are a pretty decent price if you wanna get like higher end cheeses, a little bit lower medium end cheeses. So it's not everything is like, you know, 10 bucks, 12 bucks a block. So this one, you could start in the middle. And I like to start in the middle because it just helps me when I think half, half, half. Versus start slicing from the end, it gets uneven for me. I don't cut that well. Anyway, so just a block of cheese is just gonna be sliced into rectangles and just laid on top of each other. So you see if you do a half, half, half. So this one will be too thick, so I'll probably do like a third. Okay, so just think like if you're eating a charcuterie board, how do you want it served to you? I mean, do you want a big block of, I got ruined that one. Do you want like a big block of cheese or, you know, something like that's bite size? So this one I will just eat later. So anyway, if you notice, I had washed the knife, washed my hands again because I did handle the saran wrap box and put away those bowls. The bowls of chocolate I just have sitting on the counter because that can be kind of room temperature there. It won't melt. Okay, so again here, half. And then these will be a third. And then this is where you have to put in the time or, you know, schedule in the time to cut all these. Most of the time they're not pre-cut. I mean, you can buy the pre-cut cheese that's in like cubes, which is another way to cut them. But you've got to put in the time, you know, you've got to schedule the time. Don't be like having a party at 5:30 and start doing all of this at 4. You're not gonna have enough time. Unless it's just a party for 12 people, you know, you'll have less things to cut, less charcuterie boards to put together. Okay, so I'll finish cutting this and then I have a second one. This is really good. I ate that piece that kind of got broken. Very, very good. I always look for the Vermont or an Irish cheddar. It's a good price, kind of a medium soft cheese. Most people will like it because, example for me, I don't like blue cheese, so I don't like that type of taste. So these are safe for me, safe for other people. Okay, these are the two blocks of Vermont cheddar. I'm gonna close it or cover it and then put it in the fridge. Okay, this is a new one that I saw. It's a cheddar Gruyere black truffle. So I thought this would be nice to try. You can see, I mean, who knows if it's real truffle? Probably not since it's $8.99. But anyway, it's a natural semi-hard cheese. And even here, it tells you the pairing. Pinot Noir. Okay, so you can do one, then I'll do the other one. Okay, so this one, I'm just gonna make it into a triangle. Okay, and of course you can always use a cheese cutter. Just gonna keep using my, I think the brand here is Shin. Just gonna keep using my Centuco knife here. Set it up this way and then cut off on the edge here. Okay, or you could do what I've done before where you half, half like that, but I'm just gonna go ahead and, so just so you can see that piece there. Okay. And this, two would be too much. Maybe I'll try to do three. And like I said, this is a soft cheese, so it's a little bit challenging to cut, and should probably put it back in the fridge to make it colder. It is easier to cut when it's colder. Oh, I might not be able to get this last piece. Yeah, that wasn't too good. I messed that one up. This I will eat. So this one, instead of thirds, I'm just gonna do it in half. So I'm cutting the front half and the back half. All right, by the way, it's like end of September when I'm doing this party, but I'm filming it now because I know I'm gonna do Vlogmas. So I was already planning not to put up any videos for the next couple of months because I have a whole bunch of stuff going on, which probably, hopefully I'll explain in the first video of Vlogmas. So this one I'll just do in half. But anyway, I figured let me just film the different things I'm doing, projects, events, especially it's the holiday season. I have a lot of little events that I'm doing. Like this is what I consider a little event, but it's a lot of work into it because it is a going away party for our very good friends that we've known for 2 decades. And she throws great parties, so I wanted to really give her a nice party. Okay, so anyway, that's, I'm filming this in September, showing it in December, but that's the reason. So from there, you want to cut it in half, okay? And then they're going to be laced like that, where it stands up, and it gives it more height in the charcuterie board. It may not be the most even, you know? It's not like a machine cut, but that is completely fine. So same thing here, got those two. This one, these are a little bit thick, which is not the best, but oh well. You'll just know it's handmade. See, it looks like that. And then this one, you can actually even make smaller. So you have the half there, then I can do half like that. And they can be smaller, you can do the longer width and lace it smaller like that. And it's a smaller, it'll be shorter. Or you could put it on the edge of the table and just layer it like this, like that, or not too layered. Make it more like that. So these, I'm gonna go ahead and separate them, the smaller cuts in this bowl, and then the bigger cuts that will give it more height and just a little bit more cheese in this bowl here. Then I'm gonna cut the second one. Okay, these two have a similar shape with rind on just this outside part here. And so this is Merlot, Bella Vitano, Espresso. Oh, Bella Vitano. So let's see how, oh, an international award-winning cheese. Okay, I'll show you how I'm gonna cut that. Basically, I'm just gonna cut it thin like that. Maybe someone will like the rind. And we're just gonna have long triangles. Okay, so ideally it was gonna look like this, but as you can see, it all broke apart. So it's probably gonna keep breaking apart. So what I'll do is I'll just probably lay it out like this with the long ones, and then the ones that are broken, kind of keep that part here like this, and then put the other parts kind of piled on. And I'm gonna put it on a small plate. This is like a dessert plate. Has a little bit of a lip. I got this from Amazon, love it. And I'll link, like I do with all videos, I'll link everything below and also on my Amazon store. I kind of have it listed per video. So might be here like charcuterie board essentials or whatever on my Amazon store. Then I list it individually down in the description. So these, the fun thing about things breaking is you get to try them out. Okay, so that's that. Okay, got everything cut and we are ready to go. It's 4 p.m. Party starts at 5:30. So my daughter has brought everything out and is taking out the cheese one by one. See, all the crackers are out and she already started putting things on. Had sent me by email the list of the wines and some information about it. So I just went ahead and printed it out, put a little bit of graphics there, and then put it in this frame. So it was there by the tasting table. Then over here you can see the favors. So I forgot to take a video when the party already started, and obviously when I set up the grazing table, my daughter and I did. But it is what it is, so this is what I'm showing you. So basically you take wine bottles, or you can even take the sparkling cider like this. Any type of bottle has to be tall enough. And I got both the doctor outfits and the sweaters. They came in two different types from Amazon. I'll put a link below. So basically you just take any bottle and you put the outfit on, and they do have some more stuff on Etsy, a couple more things on Amazon, but I got the idea when I was doing something for my daughter's graduation party where it was a little cap, and then I made it look like a Veuve Clicquot. So anyway, this is the sweater. It was really cute. The other ones, it had pearls, but the pearls actually came with the doctor outfits, which was interesting. And then this is the other one, the brown. So you got the plaid. So you could definitely use this for like a Christmas time. I think they have like an ugly sweater deal. And so each of our guests, whether it's a couple or individual, they took a bottle or two home. And I just mixed it up, red wine, white wine, some sparkling wine, and then non-alcoholic like sparkling cider. It was a lot of fun putting this photo backdrop together. I have this photo stand and I got two panels from Amazon. The color is either beige, tan, or champagne. I forgot, but I'll put a link in the description box below. And since they were moving from Arizona to California, California known as the Golden State for the poppies, I found flowers that are poppies. And on the left, it's Arizona. Going to the right is California. And I didn't want the cactus to be flat, so I added some flowers to give it some dimension. And you can see the colors there are kind of more, you know, like a green and blue and a little bit darker. Then it moves towards the yellow and orange and blue for the sun and the water. And so if you have a party like this, or for like a birthday or any type of event, it's always great to have a photo backdrop because it reminds you to take those pictures, and you just have something nice versus, you know, some random people in the background, you know, photobombing you. If you don't have a photo stand, then you can always use a blank wall and decorate that. So it was great to throw this party for them. They were very, very encouraged. They felt very loved. We wish them a lot of luck and all the success for their future. I love throwing parties, so I hope you enjoyed seeing this, and I'll see you in the next one. Make sure to click the next video for more of Vlogmas.